We'll be right back. Lord, everybody. Thank God for you and for connecting with us again. And we welcome you. Welcome you to another night, a Tuesday night tune-up with your bishop and pastor of Greater Pentecost Church of God, as well as your teacher. And we got another exciting class for tonight. And get your pencil and paper out. Take notes. Write down things. Go back and study it, because that's the way I'm a studious type person. And I love to study God's Word. And every time I'm in God's Word, I'm always finding something out new revelations and information that will help me to make this stride and this journey with the Lord Jesus Christ. First of all, before we get started in our lesson for tonight, I would like to thank all the saints, all of my members. We had a loss in our family. My mother lost her husband, Jim Flagg. And for the last several weeks, we've been traveling over the highways, comforting mom, being with mom while he was in the hospital. Amen. Taking the 2 and 4 to Centralia, back to St. Louis. And it was pretty well taking a toll on us mentally as well as physically. But the Lord has given us the strength with your prayers. And now we're having a funeral. And the funeral will be this Saturday morning in Centralia, Illinois, at 11 o'clock. So continue to pray for my mother, as well as the Flag and the Coleman family. And we appreciate so much, amen, your cards, your monetary gifts, as well as your prayers and your support. We appreciate it so much in the name of the Lord. Now, second thing is that I'd like to make mention that we are having a great weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We have our annual ministerial leadership retreat. Now, we normally would have it in a hotel, and we would just spend the hotel there, spend time there in the hotel with a room, and I mean, we'd have everything so laid out, and we wouldn't go home, just kind of be away from a church setting at times. So wonderful, we've been doing this for years, but because of COVID-19 and restrictions and limitations, and so we just decided to still have it, but we'll do most of it here at the church. So on Friday night, you don't want to miss it, right here at Fire Talk with Bishop and Bishop. We have our guest speaker who will be with us, and that is Dr. Venus Burton. She's going to be on Fire Talk with us. We're going to interview her, and she is a dynamite, amazing young lady that's on fire for the Lord. She's doing movies. She writes books. She has her own clothing line. She's a preacher, teacher. She has her own school called Saints of Valiant Ministry. I mean, the list goes on. She has a TV network in which you are watching even now, SOV Network, and some of the contents that we have been bringing. It's all because of Dr. Venus. We appreciate her, and she's coming to St. Louis, I think for the first time, and really for the first time in Greater Pentecostal. So we're going to have a live interview with her this Friday night at 6:30. So if you're not able to come, and this time we're going to open up a live audience. So if you would like to come and be in the live audience with us while we have this interview, you're certainly welcome to come. If not, you know, YouTube, Facebook, live, and you can see it right there, right in the confines of your home. And Saturday, amen, we'll be back here for 2 tracks, leadership, spiritual, we're talking about, I think, spiritual leadership. We're talking about leading God's people in perilous time, the spirit of perversion, spirit of excellence. They're going to do a whole lot. She's bringing a team of 2 people with her. And so we're going to have a dynamite time. You still have time to register and be a part. There will be a box lunch also on that Saturday. So everything starts at, I think, 11:30 or 11 o'clock. Somewhere in there, we'll break for lunch or a little box lunch, and then we'll go back at 1 o'clock, I think at 1:30, and we'll finish up at 3 o'clock. Ministers, leaders, prophets, whatever you are in line of ministry. And if you're not in ministry, you're certainly welcome to be with us, because it's going to be some very vital, vital information that will help you in ministry as well as encourage you in ministry. And also, she'll be back Sunday morning in our 10:30 service. So if you're not able, amen, to be with us on Saturday, you can be with us on Sunday morning at 10:30. is free to the public, no registering, nothing like that. But she will be ministering in our 10:30 morning service. You don't want to miss that. She's definitely going to be talking about the spirit of perversion. And she used to be a lesbian. God has transformed her life, changed her life, filled her up with the Holy Ghost. And she's on fire running for the Lord. And if you know anybody that want to be delivered, bring them out Sunday morning, 10:30 service. And I tell you, amen, it's going to put the devil on the run. And I just believe that somebody's going to be changed. Somebody's going to get set free. Somebody's going to see them chains and bonds being broken off of them from that lifestyle, from those spirits that have been working with them for years. God can do it because he can do the impossible. All right, we'll see you Friday. We'll see you Saturday. And we'll see you Sunday. Ministerial Leadership Conference or Leadership Retreat right here at Greater Pentecost Church of God. We would love to see you in our midst. All right? Let's say in Jesus' name. All right, you ready tonight? I'm ready. Let's go to one scripture, and that is Galatians 6 and 9. And this lesson, actually, it kind of ties in to last week's lesson when we were talking about young Timothy, and Paul was encouraging young Timothy because it seems as though he was just being worn down or getting tired, and some of the things that the saints and the church was going through during that time, during the tests and trials, and it kind of just wore him down, and Paul was encouraging his young spiritual son in the gospel, amen, to carry on, amen, this great work that's been placed in his hand. We want to go to Galatians 6 and 9. Again, it ties in with the lesson on last Tuesday night. And it reads like this: let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. I'm going to read it again. Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Now, Father, we thank you for the word that you've given us here for today, tonight's lesson from Galatians 6 and 9. I guess you will bless our hearers, those ones that are viewing with us this teaching tonight in Jesus' name. Now, the Lord gave me this morning, and really, when you look at what our challenges is and what we're facing today, and especially with COVID-19, racism, there's so much division, strife, hatred in our land, fighting among each other. I mean, it's just so much going on, and it seems that if you watch news, the media, sports, a lot of things that's going on, it will just wear on your mind what's going on in our society. And so when I look at this scripture, it's very encouraging. He says, let us, in which, you know, Paul is really just saying, I'm included in this also. You know, I can become weary. I'm including my own self in this. He didn't just say, let us not be weary, or let you not be weary in well-doing, but he said, let us. So that includes you, me, the body of Christ, preachers, pastors, evangelists, whatever line of work that you're working in the church, if you're working in the kitchen, if you're working in the children's ministry, if you're working in altar work or intercessor or praying, he says, let us not be weary in well-doing. And we know that working for God is a good work. It's a good work to do. It pays good dividends. It has good benefits. Amen. It's very rewarding when you're working for God. I know as a job, I worked on the job for 7 years. And since 1989, I haven't worked a job. Blessed be God. But I know when I did work, I had good benefits. Have health benefits, and I mean, the list goes on. I have vacations, I have personal days. Sometimes I would get raises for so many years or so many weeks on the job, you get a raise, amen. But working for God, I tell you, is great benefits, is great rewarding when you work for God. Now, when you work on a natural job, we all understand, and also in comparison to the spiritual, working and serving God, the physical job, even though you're working, some of you may enjoy the job that you have. Maybe you work for yourself. You have your own career, things like that. But regardless, the physical job can sometimes be very wearisome. I may put it that way. Sometimes you become tired, even though you enjoy what you do. Sometimes, you know, you come to a place where you need a vacation. And sometimes you say, I'm so worn down or worn out. You know, you need to take a water break or need to take a breather, as sometimes you may say. Well, when you're working and serving for God, amen, same things happen, amen, that you need to take a break. You need to, like we talk about the retreat, sometimes you have to take a retreat off of the front line, okay? Now, here's the subject is becoming weary in well-doing or be weary in warfare. And, you know, recent weeks we talked about be strong in the Lord. That's wonderful. Do that. That's check two. Number two, we talk about put the whole arm of God, put your war clothes on. That's two. You do that. Number three, we talked about praying all types of prayers because you gain your strength from having that prayer life. Okay, that's good. But tonight, we want to talk to you about growing weary in warfare. You got your war clothes on. You're praying. You're being strong. You're going out and fighting. But while you're in the spiritual battle, sometimes, amen, you will become worn out for being in the battle. Okay, now let me give you an introduction. As humans, we're all human. We got physical bodies, but we must understand that it's finite amounts of what? Of the physical strength. Finite emotional things, stress and things we got to deal with. So much that we can take. Also, mental energy, not illness, but mental energy. Amen. So there's energy in the physical, there's energy emotionally, there's energy mental. I mean, but all that, you can be drained, you can be sapped from them. Case in point, I remember in the Bible where we find there was Jesus, he said, who touched my body? He felt what? He felt the virtue to leave out of his body when the woman with the issue of blood touched him or touched his garment, and he felt, amen, something to be zapped or drained out of his body. Listen, there are times in ministry that when you're in working and serving God, you just become tired. Not that you want to backslide, and sometimes the saints, when you don't come to church or when you don't show up, sometimes you just what? You all say it, I'm just tired in my body. I worked all day long. They asked me to do a second shift or make work overtime. I just get there, and sometimes the saints point their finger, oh, you backslide. You should have been at church, but nobody knows your body. Sometimes you need to just get some rest. I know what I'm talking about. Sometimes in the mornings, I want to get up and do this. Sometimes I hear my body say, lay me down. Lay me down. Get you some rest. Rest mentally. Rest mentally. Also, you need to rest your mind. Rest your emotions, amen. Because sometimes our emotions can get out of whack and get out of place. And so when we get that proper rest, amen, we able, amen, to go back to the front line and fight some more. Because it is a spiritual battle that we are in. Now, fatigue, and when you don't get the rest, you know what happens? Fatigue sets in. After a while, and sometimes it seems like it makes a difference, amen, because you got this mind to work and do, but your body said, I just can't do it right now. And then you will find yourself, amen, that discouragement will set in. It will set in. And then here again, here's the word tells us, amen, let not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap. You will not reap the benefits of the harvest if you're tired and don't feel like what? doing and working and serving God. So that's what we want to talk to you about. Amen. Many of us are in spiritual battles. Or if not spiritual battles, sometimes we call it spiritual warfare. Okay, now, write this down. Daniel 7:25. Daniel 7:25. Watch this. And he shall speak great words against the Most High and shall wear out the saints of the Most High. Do you know that the devil, Satan, Lucifer, whatever you want to call him, amen, his job, his purpose and focus, amen, of us, amen, is to wear us down. Wear us down where you don't feel like preaching, you don't feel like teaching, you don't feel like praising God. And I know I'm talking to somebody, because there have been times where you have came to church and the praise team going forth, praise, say, come on and praise the Lord with us, and you just say, I don't even feel like raising my hand. Or somebody will say, amen, say, that's me. I don't feel like giving God the glory. Why? Because the enemy is trying to wear you down. And he does it, he don't come in just all of a sudden with it, but he wears you down gradually and gradually and gradually. He tries to wear you out where you don't feel like doing nothing for the Lord. How does he do this? Well, he'll try to wear you out through your mind. You got these pile of bills, and you're trying to figure out how I'm going to pay this or pay my bill. He will come through that way. Sometimes it can be your health. He'll wear you down. The doctor calls you and say, we found something else going on in your body. Your blood pressure is high. Over here, amen, you use your family member. Maybe your relationship with your husband or your wife, or even the children can get you down, the grandchildren. I was just in the Home Depot this morning picking up some iron for the church, and I ran across a lady and a little grandchild. I know it was a grandchild, but she was asking for something, and she looked at me and kind of smiled. I said, well, that's children. She said, no, that's my grandchild. Amen. So her little grandchild was just kind of wearing on her nerves at the moment. Amen. Because I guess she was babysitting her little grandchild for the day. Amen. But children, family, finances, your physical body, amen, these things can wear you out. And here it is. I was thinking about this today as I was putting this lesson together when we talk about be not weary in well-doing, because I believe that the devil has used COVID-19 and the Delta as a tool to wear us down. Okay, now here we are. You know, we turn the television on, get the vaccine, don't get the vaccine, take the pill, we're going to bring a pill out. Wear the mask, don't wear the mask. Go in the restaurants. You got to have maybe a vaccine card to enter. Don't come around me. Don't touch me. Wash your hands. Amen. Do this, do that. I mean, all these stipulations. You know, one of the doctors said do this. One of the county say this. City say this. It will wear you out when you hear the report. And you to the point say, man, listen, I'm sick of all this. I'm just about through with all this. Amen. It will wear your nerves down, your patience out. Amen. When you listen to the report. And all of us, amen, whether we have the vaccine or not, we're all trying to do what? The right thing. But it's just wearing us out. On the job, you got people say, have you taken it? Or have you taken it? Will you take it? It's just wearing it out. Using that too, even to the point. Now, we find that we have the church. The church. Should I go to church? Should I not go to church? Should I watch it on YouTube? I really want to be in church. I was even talking to my mother the other day as we were traveling back and forth to St. Louis and back to Centralia, and Centralia back to St. Louis, to the hospital over here. And she said, I must confess, she said, I just have been so worn out because I'm not able to go to church like I want to. I want to be in service. Well, some of our churches are not open, still not open at this time. Many of our churches are using Facebook Live and using YouTube, you know, to still connect with the saints of God. But it will wear on your patience. Amen. trying to give and pay your tithes and, amen, financially, amen, to keep the church, amen, going, even though we're not in the building. Well, it's a lot that's going on right now, amen, that will wear you down. And I believe, amen, there's a pastor out there today, you're discouraged. There are evangelists that you're not even having the meeting like you used to and traveling, amen, from city to city to be a blessing to churches, amen. So there are many discouragement. There are many folk, amen, in ministry now are just about ready to throw in the towel. But I'm here to tell you, by the word of the Lord, don't you quit, don't you give up, amen, because you're going to reap if you faint not. Now listen, when we look at that word weary, and my time is just about out, when we look at that word weary, it defines it as exhausted in strength, endurance, vigor, freshness. Okay, I've been there from time to time. You know, sometimes I'm traveling, airplane, traveling overseas, or just doing the work of the Lord right here locally. And I know what it is that you can be exhausted. I mean, not feel like going on. I'll be honest with you. I did not even preach this past Sunday morning because I was just traveling back and forth. I was helping my mom, you know, and I got to a point, I think it was on Friday night, I called my assistant pastor, Van Simon. I said, Van Simon, I said, listen, I said, I want to get one of our evangelists here at the church and let them bring the word on Sunday morning. I know I'm coming in on late on Saturday night, and I just, you know, I'm just going to be worn out in my spirit, worn out, you know, physically, amen, dealing with helping my mom, doing things like that. It wasn't that I'm trying to be some Superman, and sometimes we act like that and get all proud and lift it up in our spirit that we can just continue to do this and continue to do this. Now, I had to step back from the front line, say, listen, let me give me some rest. I got another service at 5:00, and I kind of pace myself, amen, not trying to be a super preacher or Superman, but know my limitations, amen, and preserve my body, amen, I can continue on. So listen, amen, many people right now understand about being exalted in your spirit, amen, but that's all right, because God can give us some freshness, amen. My time is up. I want to give some more. We're going to talk more about this, because we know in the Bible, in Revelation, the Bible even tells us the time is up. That's my time is up. They're letting me know. But the Bible lets us know in the book of Revelations that the devil even comes to make war with the saints. So we understand this, that there is spiritual warfare, there is spiritual battles that we're in. But here Paul is speaking to us, and let us know, let us be not weary in well-doing, where we shall, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. I'm going to be sharing with you on next Tuesday night some safeguards that will help us in that time, some guidelines when we feel like we're just burnt out. So we have to refuel, recharge, and do some things, amen, amen, stay up on the front line. I'll leave this with you. I got many power tools, and they have chargers and batteries, and I can run and operate them maybe 3 or 4 hours, or even an 8-hour job, a project I'm working on. But you know, sooner or later, that battery is going to be drained from the power or the usage of it. And so I had to take the, I'll probably just bring a charger and show you how that works. Put on the charger, and then the charge up, and it's ready to go again. You must remember that when you become weary and when you become exhausted and tired, you have to do what? Recharge. That's all I'm saying. Recharge so we continue, amen, to wait on the coming Lord. Continue to work for the Lord and serve the Lord. But sometimes we have to recharge and refuel, just like your automobile. You have to refuel, refuel up, and then you go back up and hit the road again. God bless you again. We love you. We see you this weekend. We see you Friday night. We're going to have a wonderful time. Join us. You are welcome, amen, to be with us in our ministerial leadership retreat, as well as our Sunday morning service. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.